Hello, I'm Henry Horenstein, photographer from Boston, and I want to talk to you about a new book that I'd like to do, and I'd like you to help me kickstart. The book is called Histories, Tales from the 70s, and it's called Histories because I used to be a historian, or a would-be historian, and it's called Tales from the 70s because they're pictures from the 70s. I studied for a while with E.P. Thompson, a historian in England, and his message was that a historian's job, his righteous job, he used to say, was to study the unstudied, study the people who are going to disappear from history unless someone was there, some historian was there, to capture them and preserve them. And so that's what I was studying as a historian, but it was the early 70s, and I had kind of fallen in love with photography at that point, but I had no idea how I was going to be able to transition from being a historian to a photographer. I came to Rhode Island School of Design, RISD, where I teach now, and I studied with Harry Callahan and Aaron Siskin, great photographers of the era. And essentially, Harry told me, just shoot what you love. Just go out and photograph the things that you would do anyway, even if you weren't going out to photograph, what would you do? And I told him I'd go to the racetrack and photograph the races, and I'd go to music clubs and concerts and listen to country music. And he said, well, do that, because even if you make bad pictures, you'll have a good time. And that's basically what I've done. I teach, that's where my paycheck comes from, and I do my personal photographs, personal projects. And that's what my life's been, all during the 70s. And since then, I've done projects. I've done a number of books over time, usually subject related. I did a book on country music called Honky Tonk. I did a book on horse racing called Racing Days. I did a book on my family called Close Relations. I did a book on burlesque called Show. And these were all books that collected photographs around a particular subject, a documentary subject. And now what I want to do is pull together my pictures by the decades, by the 70s, 80s, 90s, and so forth, and make this book. But a lot of the pictures are completely unseen. I photographed boxing, for example, for a book that I was doing that never got published. I photographed for the Library of Congress for a summer. Photographs that have hardly ever been seen. I photographed at Thompson Speedway, a stock car racetrack in Connecticut. Still exists, and those photographs have been virtually unseen. Many of them were pictures I really loved and really never got to show. So that's what I'm asking for help to do today. But the photographs all make sense that they're of a culture of the 70s, the style, the way people looked, the way people dressed, and the fact that they're histories, which is what photographs are, really. As they get older, they become a record of a time, whether you intend them that way or not. As it turned out, I did intend it that way. I was hoping when I photographed, I was capturing something that was going to disappear, and that I was one of the people to be able to capture that and to preserve it and to record it for the future. This book that I'm asking you to support, Histories, Tales from the 70s, is a book of my own take on that time through the worlds of boxing, country music, family, stock car racing, these kind of quirky parts of our culture and parts of our world that have disappeared. And all pictures, whether you take them or whether I take them, are time capsules of a time and people and places that are going to disappear. And that was my goal as a historian, and that is my goal as a photographer. Thank you for listening and supporting this project.